And now let's get you our tale of the tape for this heavyweight championship fight. So these fighters relatively close in age, just a year apart, with similar height and some differences in reach. We go inside the octagon. Here is Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening.
And when the action begins, our referee in charge, Herb Dean.
And now, this is the moment UFC fans around the world have been waiting for. Live from the sold-out Bell Center in Montreal, Quebec, Canada. It's time! Five rounds for the undisputed UFC Heavyweight Championship of the World. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. This man is a kickboxer, holding a professional record of 25 wins, 8 losses. He stands 6 feet 3 inches tall, weighing in at 244 pounds. Fighting out of Las Vegas, Nevada, presenting the challenger, Butcher. And now introducing the champion, fighting out of the red corner. This man is a Muay Thai kickboxer and jiu-jitsu fighter, holding a professional record of 39 wins, no losses. He stands 6 feet 2 inches tall, weighing in at 265 pounds. Fighting out of Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. Ladies and gentlemen, presenting the reigning, defending, undisputed UFC Heavyweight Champion of the World, The Destroyer.
All right, this is for the championship. You've been given your instructions in the dressing room. Protect yourself at all times. Follow my instructions. We will have a clean fight. Touch gloves. Let's make it official.
And with that touch of the gloves, we are underway. Defend his title yet again. We'll see if he can keep that trend going here tonight.
That's a big strike right there.
Oh!
He's in trouble. He's hurt bad.
All right, early round one, we'll see if he can use that jab and try to keep his opponent on the outside. Must be nice for these long fighters, huh?
I mean, they are able to touch you as you try to enter into range. Tonight, he needs to use his jab, use his kicks to hit his opponent before his opponent can get into range to even start. Think about strike.
Man, he's timing his shots nicely. It's like Tom Brady out there. He hasn't missed the target.
I mean, you insist on bringing in Tom Brady. Stop him. John, stop him.
Both guys throwing potential. Nice liver shot lands. Oh, the ground and pound strikes continue to rain down. The opponent better move out of harm's way. The referee's going to stop this.
He better start to move. And when his opponent starts to posture, he needs to put his feet on the hip, push it away, and try to escape this very, very dangerous position.
Starting to do some really significant damage to the body here. Another strike lands there. Oh, worked hard to get up again, but he looks like he's compromised.
What a beautiful takedown.
And he gets the single leg takedown.
Nice guillotine tip here.
Then he's out. Well, he continues to manhandle him here on the ground. And back to his feet.
Look at how he turns his hip into that leg kick.
Back and forth we go here.
Big.
Oh!
Oh, he's hurt bad. He's hurt bad, John. He's got to press him. He's got to go chase that finish down now.
Oh!
Good right here.
Oh, he might be out. Shot to the body. He told us he was going to be champion. Mission accomplished.
Mission accomplished. It does not get much better than that. Look at how fast. The only person I can do this to is maybe John. John, there's a weight difference. I don't know if you know jiu-jitsu much. You just got out of your class.
Shot right on the button.
I'm getting shot. That is the most debilitating shot in all of fighting. hurting, you don't know when that leg kick's coming.
Oh, God. Oh, right under the elbow, right on the
perfect. It was a perfectly placed shot, and you see his opponent reacting violently from that punch. He ate that kick. He took that whole kick, yep.
All right, he'll engage in a single collar tie. Oh! 5 minutes in the books. So a high-level round there for him. We'll show you some of the action here, and you got to think the knockdown is going to be featured prominently here. Thought he might have had him out of there.
He thought he had him, but the guy's tough. The guy's durable. He has a fantastic chin, but he just needs to stay the course. He does not need to be discouraged. Think about this. You're winning, and you're winning going away. That was just a moment. Keep going in the same direction, and you will get the finish that you want so bad.
You ready to fight? Ready.
All right, round two. Huge block there. Oh!
Dude's hurt. Serve him up. Go get him.
Oh, really using his reach. He just digs into the body. And just like that, the fight is over.
He's done. What a performance.
Yeah, that was just a gorgeous shot to end the fight right there. I'm not even sure the opponent really saw it coming. So back to the drawing board for him. But for the winner, this is certainly exactly what he was looking for here tonight. All right, let's get you some replays now. Certainly a lot for our replay guys to work with in the truck. This was a clinic tonight in terms of mixed martial arts acumen in every realm of the game.
A full-on display of all of his skills. He did everything in this championship-winning performance. He used his wrestling. He used his elbows. He used his pace and pressure to really wear down his opponent so that he can get his hand raised.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Herb Dean has called a stop to this contest at 24 seconds of round number two, declaring the winner by knockout and still the undisputed UFC heavyweight champion of the world, the Destroyer.
Well, he came in with the moniker of baddest man on the planet, and that is exactly the way he goes out. Congratulations.